Hi everyone, it's Rebecca with Linking Lewis County, and on today's episode of Hear All About It, we have Meghan Harney, who is the director of the Lowville Free Library. Welcome, Meghan.
Thanks
for stopping in. You're here to talk to about a couple of things as far as the library. Let's start with the Food for Fines program first.
Yeah, so from November 1st to November 18th, we are doing Food for Fines. And that is a program where people can bring in a donation of food, all of which will go to Lowville Food Pantry, and we will waive overdue fines on books.
Okay, now I'm assuming this is non-perishable foods?
Yes.
Okay.
Yep, anything that the food pantry would normally take.
Okay, so
they are asking for things for Thanksgiving, the Thanksgiving
specific
boxes that they do, so turkey gravy and stuffing, cranberry sauce, but of course they'll accept any of the normal items.
Right, I believe they do non-perishables, and probably people could use the hygiene products and those kinds of things too. Okay, so what are you, is it one item takes away one fine? How does that work?
Yeah, so we are doing a suggested donation of one food item for $1 in fines, and that's overdue fines. It doesn't cover if an item is lost. But we know that there are long overdue items, things that, you know, people have probably just forgotten about or that kind of thing. And so if they want to bring back the item and a donation of food, then we'll waive the overdue fines that would accompany it.
What is the protocol if the item is lost, just in case people don't know?
Yeah, so we encourage people, if there's things that on their account that they can't find, to just come in and talk to us about it, and we'll work out a solution.
Go from there.
Finding the price.
So the Food for Fines, again, it's a week-long program.
It's a couple weeks, actually, the 1st to the 18th.
Okay.
Yeah.
And do you want people to call ahead before they come?
Nope. They can just come anytime during library open hours, and they can just bring their donation to the desk, and we'll take care of the fines from there.
Okay. And don't just drop at the door and go, I'm assuming.
Right.
Better to come
because then we won't know whose account to apply the donation to.
Right.
We are also, you know, of course, accepting any donations for Lowville Food Pantry, even if someone doesn't have fines on their account. We will gladly take donations.
Right, accept those and deliver.
Yeah,
right.
So that they, just to get them as we go into the holiday season.
Perfect. It's a great time, perfect time of year to be doing it, and also to get rid of your fines and do it in a way you feel good about.
Yes.
So that's great. The other program you're here to talk about is the fall book sale.
Yeah, so we have a book sale one to a few times a year.
Mm-hmm.
So this is our fall book sale. We set it up downstairs at the library and just have a whole range of books. We'll have fiction, nonfiction, large print books. We'll have limited availability of children's and audiobooks, DVDs, things like that.
Okay, and we talked about with that one, also, that's definitely not a drop and leave, that you want people to call.
Right, so people can come to the book sale anytime during the days that we're doing it. So that's November 4th, 5th, and 6th. We are accepting donations up until the book sale, and we'd be glad to just incorporate those into our book sale this time around. But we do ask, if anyone wants to make a donation, to not just leave it, to bring it in while the library is open, and ideally to call ahead.
Sure. And we were also just talking about things that cannot be donated. So
yes, there are a few things that we don't accept donations of. We don't take dictionaries, encyclopedias, textbooks, and Reader's Digest.
Okay. And is your donation supply, we were talking earlier that because of COVID you haven't been really able to do a lot of book sales. Do you feel that you have a large variety, or are you really looking for people to go through and heavily donate for the sale?
Yeah, so our storage has been filled up. We weren't able to take donations for a large portion of time during COVID, but we're glad to take them now, and we'll put them right in the book sale. for donations after the book sale, you can just check in with us. I'm not sure what position we'll be in.
Okay. What? How do you typically price the books at the book sale?
So it's usually just flat prices for hardcover, paperback, and so it's really quick and easy to just, you know, you can just browse and then quick and easy to add.
Okay, and do you guys, you're fully staffed for that? You're not looking for any volunteers during that time at all?
Not necessarily, but you know, if anyone is interested in volunteering at the library, they're always welcome to stop in and talk to us about it.
Not only for this program, but this several programs, wonderful programs, I should say, that you guys have there. Now, we should also mention, do you have a Facebook page?
We do, yeah. So we have Facebook and Instagram. Okay. We're at Lowville Free Library on both of those, so easy and straightforward. Our website is lowvillefreelibrary.org. Okay. And we do have the information about food for finds, including a list from Lowville Food Pantry of items on there. And so that's lowvillefreelibrary.org/food drive.
Okay, so the Facebook page, the website for these two programs, and any of your programs, I'm assuming all your programs are listed on there?
They are.
Okay, so just to wrap things up, tell us again the dates for the Food for Finds.
Yeah, so Food for Finds will be running November 1st through 18th.
Okay, and the fall book sale?
Is November 4th, 5th, and 6th.
Okay, excellent.
Yeah.
All right, well, we really appreciate you stopping in. Our library is a great little library, and we really appreciate all the work you guys do.
Well, thanks for having me.
Thank you.
Yeah.